This is the faceplate itself, and this little indentation is where you could reach your fingernail in or take a screwdriver, but honestly, I would just do gentle. I'd use your fingernail and press into here, and you can pop out the older faceplate that's cracked. Let me show you here. Like that. Okay, so I would do that and then just simply remove the broken faceplate. On the inside, this area here, you know, the faceplate is there to provide two things. It provides some protection of those internal components, and it also provides a hard, transparent surface for doing oil dermoscopy. So if you're okay not doing oil dermoscopy while you're waiting for your new faceplate, then to be honest, you can just simply use it like this. Everything here will get you what you need as far as using the dermatoscope without the faceplate. This really isn't that fragile, the inner components. It's just that it may be a little bit more prone to getting dust and dirt on the inside, but honestly, you're not talking about waiting very long in order to receive the faceplate. And as long as you're careful not to expose it, then just when you get the new faceplate, you could probably get one of those air sprayers like you use for the computer, blow out this area here, and if there are any other spots, you could use those satin type of cloths that are used for cameras. You could use that to clean out. But honestly, unless you really, really do something like touch the inside, I doubt you'll even need that. Maybe just a quick blowout with one of those dusters. But at least when you remove it, it will remove any cracked glass from obscuring your view within the dermatoscope.